What's up, bitches? Ghostface here, and today we're continuing Deadly Premonition. Okay, so let me just remember. Oh yeah, this shit. So what was number 23, 26, and 14? Okay, that's one. Now this, if you push it this way, it will go off the shit and you will have to reload because it is totally bugged. So don't make the mistake I made and just push it here. Because number is 26 anyway. There we go. Let's follow the trail. Okay, we're here. Damn.
Harry, turns out what you said was true, and I'd like to hear more.
York, as you know, there's a powerful mystery surrounding these seeds. You've seen them at those other murders that took place elsewhere.
And you've seen them deeply involved with the murders in this town as well.
That's right. But how do you know all this?
York, you must be younger than you look. Youngsters tend to hurry so much that they let things slip right past them.
What you need to do is slow this down a bit. That way you'll see what's really important. Let me tell you a story. 50 years ago, when the war was over, just about when the Communist Red started to become rising threat, our town constructed a huge clock tower. Then, soon afterwards, a serial killer wearing a red raincoat went on a killing spree.
The Legend of the Raincoat Killer? Stop playing games with me, Harry. That's nothing more than folklore. The FBI has no such record of a multiple homicide case in this town.
York, Anna, Becky, and now Diane. Their deaths are real, not folklore, not legend. The Raincoat Killer is also real. But under a strict gag order, the mass murder case was never made public. In fact, one could say that it was completely erased from history. Tell me, who do you think would be able to do something like that?
The military.
Damn, boy.
Very good. A model student.
But if there are no records about it, then how do you know it really happened?
Good question, York. Why would I know this? The answer is very simple. I was there. I saw it with my own eyes. The brutal killer himself. But we can talk about the details of that encounter another time. What we need to talk about is your Raincoat Killer. The new Raincoat Killer, if you will. The new Raincoat Killer. Yes, let's call him that.
So he's a copycat.
After all, he's not the real one. What you want to know more about is the new one. Between 10 and 20 years ago, I noticed that these red seeds were special. And someone else did too. The human imagination can lead to tragedy sometimes. Someone linked the red seeds to the serial killer legend and said, if you eat the red seeds and then kill someone, you will become immortal. This new fabricated legend was passed on from one to the next, evolving and changing every time, like a rumor. Some may have actually taken the seeds to try them out, to prove the legend, that is.
York, the red seeds you have found from those other murders, they all came from this town. Together with that one evil rumor.
People on the other side of the planet may have heard of it by now. And new seeds might be growing in different parts of the world.
So you're saying that the series of cases I've been following are all linked to this town? That's interesting, Harry. But there's no evidence to support that story. None of the criminals we caught for the other murders ever mentioned anything like that.
It's your job, your role and duty to look into that, York. Now, the game must go on. You know I said that the incident 50 years ago was totally erased? Well, not quite. Records still exist in the sheriff's office. The old sheriff back then hated the military and did his own investigation. I need you to bring those documents here, to me. Once you've done that, I'll tell you everything I know.
Okay, it's worth a look. And we may as well let the old man have his fun.
Okay, I guess another chapter. Well done.
Documents from a case that happened 50 years ago. Let's play along with the old man for a little longer, shall we?
Zack, that means we need to head for the sheriff's department.
Okay, no problem.
Can there really be documents here that the FBI doesn't even have? What do you think, Zack?
Maybe.
York! I told you! That's nothing more than local folklore!
Harry said that he was there.
The Raincoat Killer is a phantom, made up to scare children long ago. I can't believe you fell for that from Harry, of all people.
I agree with George. Harry likes to play with people. Play with their minds, too.
George, Emily. Of course I don't believe him word for word. But you won't mind if I at least try to confirm that he's wrong, will you?
Well then, can you look for the files by yourself? I'm still looking for Thomas.
Very well.
Emily, open the filing room for him.
What's this now?
They're here too, Zack.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
This might mean we're getting warmer to what we need.
Let's see, can I? Yes, I can.
Too much noise. We're still missing a vital piece of the puzzle.
Okay, what are we missing? Something here, obviously. Someone removed something. Broken safe? Now that is very suspicious. Okay, good thing I can avoid them all. Ah, shit! I cannot avoid them.
Amazing. Yes, nice shot. Nice shot. Great. Amazing. bullseye. Yes.
Fucking hell.
Nice shot. Amazing. Great.
Fuck you.
Nice shot. Yes. Amazing. Yes. Nice shot. Yes. Nice shot.
What now? And this is what? I don't need it. Oh, for fuck's sake.
Nice shot. Yes, amazing.
Okay, something here. Red seed. Okay, just one more now. Oh, for fuck's sake. Tell me I can enter here? Yes.
Zach, looks like we need to continue our search for the documents.
George, I'll get right to the point. It looks like someone else has just removed the documents I'm looking for.
Huh? Removed?
The cabinet looks like it had been forced open.
That's impossible. No one could break into there.
No, Emily. There is one person that can access that room at any time.
You don't mean Thomas?
It's too early to speculate. And profiling is my job, remember? More importantly, Emily, could you get me a coffee? A fresh one, if possible.
Coffee? At a time like this? Why now?
Emily, please. This is very important. Some coffee. And bring some milk on the side.
He wants to get letters again.
Zach, you know something, don't you? I'm getting us some coffee. So tell me what you know.
Ugh.
Zach, this is amazing. Even the taste of her coffee is thrilling, to say the least.
What?
No, nothing. This isn't the cup that Thomas always uses for me, is it?
I'm sorry about that too, then. I just used a cup that was nearby. You have a problem with that?
A problem? Not at all, my dear Emily. The coffee is perfect. Well, okay, taste aside, this cup certainly is perfect. George, Emily, we're going to Velvet Falls. There's something waiting for us there. I can feel it.
York, are you joking? You're trusting your cup?
No, Emily. Going to a waterfall just might be a good idea. In feng shui, a waterfall is known to be a source of power. Even if we find nothing there, I'm sure it will give us some power.
Thanks for the vote of confidence, George. And don't forget to bring a fishing rod.
All right. I'll go get it.
Fishing? Are you too serious?
George, do you have a net?
Another chapter well completed. New Raincoat Killer.
Zach, I hope we can catch a big one.
I have to fish. Fuck yeah.
Good fishing, Zach. We've caught something to brag about now. In all the history of the FBI, I'm probably the only one who fished out documents thrown into a waterfall. Don't you think so, Zach?
I just don't believe it. Files from a waterfall. What does that all mean?
It's called the Legend of the New Raincoat Killer. George, have you ever seen this handwriting?
Yes. It's Thomas's.
George, I need to take these documents to Harry. He said he'd tell me everything once I take the docs to him.
But those are classified. I can't allow a civilian to view them. Especially that deranged old goat who owns most of the town.
I agree with George. Harry is... how can I put it? He might be dangerous.
You don't need to worry. You said it yourselves, didn't you?
There has never been a mass murder case in this town. That means these documents pertain to a case that never actually happened. Just look at it as though they never actually existed either.
Ridiculous.
York, I'm sure you've got a plan or something in mind? Okay. You have my approval.
George, are you sure?
Emily, we need to continue looking for Thomas. Our search may just have become a hunt.
Yes, get on it. I'll go see Harry alone.
Okay.
I wouldn't believe it if I hadn't seen it for myself. But Thomas?
There's got to be a rational explanation for this.
Zach, George has started to change. I think the deaths of Becky and Diane had a deep effect on him.
I guess this town truly is without a king now.
Okay then, Zach. Let's pay Harry another visit and get to the bottom of all this.
I have to admit, I do like spending a bit of time investigating alone.
I'm getting a bit sick of being told that I'm either too slow or too fast. You agree with me, right, Zach?
Mr. Francis York Morgan, finally you have arrived. You are welcome to come inside.
What now?
Looks like the next game is hide and seek.
Oh, yeah.
Huh?
What now?
These girls, Zach. Do you see the resemblance? Anna, Becky, she looks like Diane, and Carol. Zach, look. Emily.
Fucking bullshit.
Shot. Great. Nice shot. Nice shot. Great. Bullseye.
What now?
Great. Yes. Yes.
Just great. Okay, let's do this shit. Are you fucking kidding me? I hear some dog.
Amazing. Great. Great. Amazing. Yes. 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 Great. Yes. Yes. Nice shot.
Well, this is bullshit.
Yes. Great. Bullseye. Amazing. Nice shot. Bullseye.
Yeah.
shot. Bullseye. Yes. Amazing.
Great.
Yes. Bullseye. Amazing. Amazing. Amazing.
Nice shot. Great.
Finally. Oh, well, this is fucked up.
Emily.
At times we must purge things from this world because they should not exist. Even if it means losing someone that you love.
Stop!
Zach, did you see that? I must be getting tired.
What now, man? Oh, finally.
Zach, looks like we're out of the countryside and back in civilization.
Welcome, York.
I brought the documents. Just what is going on in here?
I warned you about haste. Take it slow. You'll lose sight of what's important if you just rush past it. As an agent of the FBI, I'm sure you know. So many people have got it all wrong. They think speed is the key. That being first is the best. They want speed, and are satisfied with what the speed brings. Even if it means that they miss so much on the way, they don't even see that. I see everything that they don't. From here, I see it all. Then, when the time comes, I make use of what I've seen. I can get whatever I want in this way. Anything at all.
You're certainly talkative today, Harry. But I didn't come here for a business lecture. Tell me everything you know.
Speed is not important. Timing is what is important. Timing.
York, you have a natural gift for waiting for the correct timing.
Just be careful that your haste does not ruin everything. That will be vital to solving the current case at hand.
York, I know more than you think, but less than what you hope.
One, you have Nick in custody. Two, Thomas is missing. Three, Carol has a locket that belongs to the murderer. I also know that this case revolves around the Red Seeds. But that's about it.
So you've got an inside line on police information.
That reminds me. The victims' tongues were cut out, weren't they? But that's only a minor point. Don't let the shocks blind you to what's more important. That's another business tip.
Harry, I'm impressed. You gather information really well. You hacked into the FBI network, too. Amazing. But I didn't come here to hear this.
Then let us close the business seminar. It's time for a history lesson instead. I remember it as though it were yesterday, if you'll pardon the cliché. It was dark, raining, a foggy night. My parents, who normally got along, were fighting over something. My father was blaming my mother, it seemed. So I left the house, headed for the clock tower. There was a party being held that day to celebrate the tower's completion. I wanted to see the town from above, and so I decided to climb the tower. Curious child. I saw it being constructed day after day. I'm not sure why, but I was really drawn to the tower in some way. And that's why I knew. From the pit in the theater, there's a path to the clock. They were just cleaning up after the party, so it was easy to get into the theater. I used the secret passage to sneak into the tower. But when I reached the top, I saw something very strange. There were soldiers there, all wearing gas masks. Device was emitting purple smoke outside. Just then, for the first time, the bell rang throughout the town. I reacted with fear and left the tower as fast as I could.
Oh, that's where he...
I unconsciously counted the number of times the bell rang. After the 12th time, the bell did not stop ringing. It rang a loud 13th time.
That's why he still wears a gas mask.
Thank you.
What the fuck?
Expression I have never seen before. Later, next. I am sorry, but that did not stop him from attacking me. Anymore, and the purple fog was gone. I couldn't believe what I saw and what I myself had done. But even worse things were waiting for me when I got home. My mother was dead. Killed, presumably, also by my father. The next day, the town was overrun by military personnel. That's when the gag order was issued. Talking about the incident was unappreciated, a taboo. But even still, people stopped going outside when it rained. Country folk are very patriotic. We never tell our children about what happened. But these things find a way out of even the tightest of lips, in parts. People only speak of the killer in the red raincoat, which is where the legend of the Raincoat Killer comes from.
Quite a story.
After the incident, the gas seeped into the soil of the town. Even today, when it rains, a minute amount is released. That's why I never take my mask off when I'm outside. This town is dirty, York.
What did I say?
If what you say is true, then the killer is someone who is badly affected when it rains.
You need to draw the conclusions, not I. I have no conclusions.
Is there a connection between the red seeds and the gas, then?
This is just my own presumption. The seeds and the gas have a similar effect on our nervous systems. I believe someone figured that out and decided to use it. Or it could just be nature's way of getting back at us humans.
York! Good news! You'll hear from George soon. They have found Thomas.
I'll tell you one last and very important thing. Just as you suspected, everything I have told you is gibberish. I never hacked into the FBI server, and I certainly know nothing about the red seeds. I shall thank you for listening to an old man, Babylon.
Let me ask you one thing then, Harry. You're a businessman. You must be after something in return for giving me this information.
York, at times we must purge things from this world because they should not exist.
Dad.
Even if it means losing someone that you love.
But that still does not justify murder.
Remember this. Everything changes in form. There isn't a single thing that can maintain its shape for eternity. Overlook this fact, and you'll be making a big, big mistake.
It's raining.
York, We found Thomas.
Ah. He's at his house, right?
How did you know that?
Timing, Emily. Good timing.
Ugh, whatever. Just get in. George is heading over there already. Let's get a move on.
Zach, things are finally starting to come together. All we need now is for Thomas to fill in the blanks in our new legend.
Oh, we're driving something different now. Yeah, do you see how?
George, what's happening?
We received an anonymous call informing us that Thomas returned home. I sent Emily to get you right away.
No idea who made the call?
No. That's why I came on ahead, to see if the information was correct. A light did come on, but only for a second. I saw a tall male silhouette in the window. It was Thomas.
Okay. I'm going in then. You two wait here.
We'll be ready to burst in at any moment. Just call out.
Zach, it's the same in the countryside after all. The climax of an investigation is always in an apartment.
Fucking profiling.
Too much noise. We're still missing a vital piece of the puzzle.
Okay, red wig.
Huh.
Huh?
So, Thomas wants us to look around for him a bit more. So there's more to it. Kind of like the bonus footage on a DVD. I hope it's worth watching. Don't you agree, Zach?
York? What was that noise? Damn it! We need to seal off all routes out of town.
No need for that, George.
Huh?
If he was going to leave town, he would have done so by now. Which means he's still got some unfinished business.
Fuck.
Zach, do you think they heard what I said?
We don't have to make a fuss. Thomas isn't going to leave town. That gives us plenty of time to find a way to view the bonus footage.
Okay, I'll finish this part here, and I have a feeling that the next one will be the final one. So I'm gonna see you soon.